Do you know all the bones in a dinosaur?
I think I'll learn them. I'll learn all the bones.
Welcome to the Natural History of Dinosaurs. My name is Benjamin Berger. I'm a paleontologist teaching at Utah State University in the heart of Utah's dinosaur country in Vernal. Now in this video, I'm going to teach you the various names of the bones found in a typical dinosaur skeleton. Now, many of these bones carry the same anatomical names for bones that are found in your own body. We'll be using the well-known late Triassic dinosaur Plateosaurus, known from several hundred rather complete skeletons from southwestern Germany. Now, Plateosaurus is a great dinosaur to study because it's primitive and it lacks many of the specialized horns, frills, spikes, and plates that we'll see in later dinosaurs. Plateosaurus is a member of a group of dinosaurs called protosauropods, which are a group ancestral to the giant long-necked dinosaurs like Apatosaurus, Diplodocus, and Brachiosaurus. I'm going to quickly sketch a rather complete Plateosaurus skeleton, starting with the skull and then the cervical vertebrae, dorsal vertebrae, with ribs extending down and closing the chest and abdomen. The sacrum, and finally the caudal vertebrae that form the tail. Now extending from the axis of the skeleton are four limbs, composed anteriorly of the large scapula and round coracoid, articulating with the upper arm bone, the humerus, the two forearm bones, the radius and ulna, meeting the wrist bones called carpals, hand bones called metacarpals, and the finger bones, the phalanges. Now on the back, we have three bones that form the hips. I'm going to sketch the hips separately. The ilium lays on top against the sacrum. The pubis projects in front, and ischium projects out the back. Where these three pelvic bones meet extends the femur, or upper leg bone. Now the femur is attached to the tibia and fibula in the lower leg. The ankle bones are the larger astragalus, which in dinosaurs often fuses with the tibia, and the calcaneum on the fibula side of the ankle. The metatarsals are the foot bones and the phalanges or toe bones. Clawed end bones are called the ungual phalange bones. So let's go over the names of bones with my friend here, Mrs. Skelly. Now just like in Plateosaurus, Mrs. Skelly has a skull and she has a long row of vertebrae which include the cervical vertebrae of the neck, the dorsal vertebrae of the back, and then we have the sacrum down here, which is a group of fused vertebrae that are forming a single bone. And then, even though we don't have a tail or a caudal vertebrae in dinosaurs, we do have some vestigial caudal vertebrae, and that's called the coccyx bone. Just like Plateosaurus, Mrs. Skelly has a pectrogirdle with a scapula, which in humans is fused to the coracoid. And Mrs. Skelly has a clavicle. Now clavicle's right here. It's this bone here. And surprisingly, we don't have any clavicles from any of the Plateosaurus skeletons. But some similar dinosaurs like Mesospondylus may have had clavicles. In some advanced dinosaurs, the right and left clavicles fuse to form a new bone called the furcula, which is the wishbone in birds. Now some folks think that the furcula instead fused from an inner clavicle, which is a bone found in primitive reptiles, platypuses, and echidnas, strangely enough. We'll talk more about the furcula bone when we look at theropods and the origin of birds. Now extending from the scapula, we have the humerus. It's quite humorous. Let me see your hand, Mrs. Skelly. So we have the humerus, and then we have the radius and the ulna. Then we have the carpal bones, which are the wrist bones, the metacarpal bones, which are the hand bones, and the phalanges. Now in the hips, Mrs. Skelly has fused her three pelvic bones. The ilium right here, which forms this blade, and then we have the pubis that sticks out in front here. That's the pubis bones.
And then we have the back butt bone right here. And that bone there is called the ischium. Now the articulation of the femur, this bone, into the hip socket is called the acetabulum. Now the femur is connected to the tibia and the fibula, just like in Plateosaurus. And the ankles contain the same two bones, the calcaneum and the astragalus, which is right here. Now in dinosaurs, the astragalus is often fused with the tibia, and the calcaneum in humans is much bigger than it is in dinosaurs. It's oftentimes a small bone next to the fibula. And then we have the tarsal bones, which are sort of the body of the foot there, the metatarsal bones, the body of the foot, and then phalanges, and the very tip, little pinky, end of the pinky toes, end of the toes here, are what are called the ungual phalanges, which in dinosaurs can be clawed and quite vicious, and in Mrs. Skelly, they're kind of dainty. We share a lot in common in terms of the names of the bones with dinosaurs.
There are a few terms that we should know about the vertebrae. The centrum is the drum-like part of each vertebrae that in life were interspersed with a cartilaginous intervertebral disc. As a big sturdy part of the vertebra bone, and as such, the centrum is often found as fossils. The spinal cord travels down the top of the centrum through an arch called the neural arch. Now most dinosaurs also have tall neural spine along their dorsal vertebrae to protect their spinal cord. In the caudal vertebrae, there's an arch below the centrum called the hemal arch, or chevron. Now let's turn to the bones of the skull. There are three bones that contain teeth in dinosaurs. The premaxilla at the front, the maxilla in back, forming the upper jaw, and the denary, forming the lower jaw. Notice that in dinosaurs, the lower jaw is composed of many bones. Posterior or behind the denary, and these include the angular at the angle of the jaw, the surangular above the angle of the jaw, and a small bone called the articular, which articulates with the quadrate bone of the skull. In the skull, the bones forming the bridge of the nose are called the nasals, with the prefrontals and frontal bones forming the forehead bones. Now below the frontals in the corner of the orbit or eye socket is the lacrimal. On the lower edge of the eye socket is the jugal, which is the cheekbone, and in the back corner of the eye socket or orbit is the postorbital. The brain case is enclosed by the parietal bone on top and the squamosal on the side and the occipital behind, which has a door handle-like projection called an occipital condyle, which articulates with the first cervical vertebrae. The big opening is for the spinal cord, and it's called the foramen magnum. Unlike mammals, which have two, dinosaurs have a single occipital condyle. Near the back of the skull are the quadrate and quadrajugal bones. Now note that in dinosaurs, there are multiple openings in the skull. The most anterior are the nares for the nostrils, the anteorbital opening along the side of the nose. The middle one in the back is the eye socket or orbit, and in the way back there are two openings separated by the postorbital and squamosal bones. We'll talk about the importance of these openings in a later video. Now there are other bones beside these, including the hyoid bone, which is found in the neck for neck muscle attachments. And it's seen here in this wonderful specimen of a Plateosaurus. You can also see cervical spines extending from the cervical vertebrae. Now some dinosaurs have belly ribs, and these are called gastrula, which you can see in this skeleton from Germany of Plateosaurus, all jumbled below the skeleton, like a stick, bunch of sticks there. That's called the gastralia. Now, I recommend memorizing the names of the bones found in a typical dinosaur like Plateosaurus, including many of those bones that we went over in the skull. We'll be referring to these names frequently throughout the rest of this class. So be sure to memorize the names of the bones found in a typical dinosaur, including many of the bones of the skull.